you've had your eyes examined and you've got your prescription, but all you really see is just a bunch of numbers. In this video, we're going to have a closer look at your prescription, and I'm going to help you to understand what it really means once and for all. Hi, I'm Martin Oguzie, and this is Martin's Eye Tips. Thank you for joining me. On this channel, we're all about bringing you eye care tips, how-to videos, and product reviews, all designed to help you see better, see more comfortably, and to be less anxious about your eyes. So please consider subscribing if you're new to the channel. Hit the notification bell if you do as well. That way you get reminded every time I release a new video. So today, this video is all about your prescription, and we're gonna get straight into that right now. So for this video, if you've got your glasses prescription to hand, I suggest you pull that out right now, and then you can follow along as we go through the boxes in the prescription. So this is what a prescription for glasses will look like. Now, because it's personalized to you, it must have your name on it and be signed by the prescribing optometrist, who will also have their practice details on the prescription as well. It'll also have some other detail on there as well, like the recall time for your next eye examination. And then it may or may not have a pupillary distance measurement. Now, the PD or pupil distance measurement is not usually mandatory, so this may or may not be on the prescription as well, because really it's expected that whoever dispenses your glasses will make this measurement at the time of dispensing themselves. Now, your prescription will always be separated into the right eye and the left eye. Now, here in the United Kingdom, where I live and work, it's nice and simple. Each eye is labeled right eye and left eye, or R and L. Now, in other parts of the world, rather than saying right and left, it may say OD and OS. And these are Latin abbreviations for the words oculus dexter for OD, which simply means right eye, and also oculus sinister, which means the left eye. So a little bit confusing, but that's basically what it means. So wherever you are in the world, you have a section for right eye and a section for the left eye measurements. So looking at the columns that you'll find in the prescription, the first box is usually the sphere, which is often abbreviated to SPH. The sphere box is a lens power measurement that tells us whether you have nearsightedness or farsightedness. It's worth noting that all lens powers are measured in units that we call diopters, and this is often denoted with a capital D. And the sphere power may be a plus positive number, or it could also be a minus negative number. If it's a positive plus power, that indicates that you have farsightedness, which is also called hyperopia. If it's a negative minus power, then it indicates that you have nearsightedness, which is also called myopia. Now, the larger the number after the plus or the minus sphere is an indication of how nearsighted you are or how farsighted you are. And the next two boxes are the cylinder and the axis. The cylinder is often abbreviated as just the sil. And these two numbers go hand in hand. So whenever you see the sil and the axis present in your prescription, this indicates that you have astigmatism. Now, for a fuller explanation of what astigmatism is, you can check out a video that I made previously on the eye astigmatism explained, and that's in the top right corner just over there. Now, the sil is usually a negative number and is a measure of the power needed to correct your astigmatism. The higher the number is, the more astigmatism you have. Now, the axis, on the other hand, is not a power measurement, but rather it's a location measurement and tells us in degrees where the laboratory needs to position your sil in order to line up with your astigmatism and to correct it. And the axis can be any number between 0 degrees to 180 degrees. Now, in a more detailed prescription report, you may also find a box for prism and prism base. And a prism is an optical power that is worked into the lens to treat people with double vision or eye coordination problems, and it helps eliminate double vision. And prism power is measured in prism diopters, and the base is really just a location where we want to put the base of that prism, and that can be up, down, left and right. Now, most people never need a prism, so they'll never see anything written in the prism or the base box. And the other number that is common to find in your prescription is called the AD. Now, the AD is usually an additional reading power that we add on top of your distance prescription, and that combination makes up the glasses that you need for reading. The AD can also be an intermediate AD, and that's a power that we give to correct distances in between your reading and your far sight. So this, for example, could be for computer use, or if it could be for any other hobbies that you may have in between distances as well. And this distance is worked out precisely, and then the intermediate ad helps you to have clear focus for that distance. Now, the reading aid is quite common for us all to experience from about the age of 40 to 45. Our manual focusing just starts to fail and we start to then need this additional focusing help close up. Now, that happens regardless of whether or not you choose to wear reading glasses. That process still happens, and it's a process that we call presbyopia. You can find out more about that in a previous video that I've made just by clicking the link in the top right corner, and that will take you to that video. And that there really is the essentials of understanding your glasses prescription. Now for my peace of mind point. Now, if you recently picked up your glasses prescription and you're concerned because it looks drastically different to what you might have had previously, then it may not be anything to worry about at all. Now, it could just be because of a process that we call transposition, which means that your prescription can have one of two forms that are identical and produce identical vision to the individual looking through. So the way to know whether the difference could be due to transposition is to have a look at the seal box and make sure that they're the same sign. So either they both should be minus or they both should be plus. If one's plus and one's minus, you know that they've been transposed differently. So why do we transpose lenses in the first place? Well, have a look at these two prescriptions here and you'll see that they look drastically different, but they actually are the same prescription. Just one's converted to one form with the plus seal and the other one is converted to the same prescription with a negative seal. Now, you do get optometrists from the previous generations that were using the plus seal form that still continue to do so. And that may be why you may go to one practice and they're writing it in plus, and in another practice, they're writing it in negative. Now, there is an advantage to having the two forms. And one example could be that, for example, a lab who's making up your glasses, they may choose one form over the other because it may help to hide the edge thickness of your prescription. So if you're somebody who is quite a high prescription, then you may find that in, for example, the plus form or the negative form, it may determine where the sides of your lenses are thicker or whether the top and the bottom are thicker. Now, often it can look cosmetically better if we put the thickness on the top and bottom rather than the sides. It's because people see the sides more than they do the top and bottom. So that's one advantage and allows your optometrist and your practice to be able to choose one form over the other, just for that cosmetic benefit. So the bottom line is, if you do find a big difference between your prescriptions from one visit to another, particularly if you've been to one practice in 1 year and to a different practice another year, then the first thing you want to do is to be able to kind of have a look at the seal and make sure that they are both plus or both minus. So check that out first before being overly concerned. And now for my tip of the day. So my tip today is just a little bit of guidance to help you to have a look at your prescription and get an idea, an indication of how that level of prescription will impact your vision on the eye test chart. So as a general rule of thumb, if you are short-sighted, then every minus 0.25 of prescription power that you've got will lose you about one line on the eye test chart. So for example, if you are minus one, then you can expect to be round about four lines above the 20/20 or the 6/6 line. So if you're farsighted and you are under the age of 40, the good news is that you're going to be able to compensate for your prescription a lot more and absorb a lot more long-sightedness before it starts to significantly impact your vision. And you may find that you might need about a plus one in prescription before you lose about a line on the eye test chart. For people who are farsighted and about the age of 60, then you'll find that again, every plus 0.25 will probably lose you about a line on the eye test chart as well. So if you are about plus one, then you'll find again, you'll probably be about four lines above the 6/6 or the 20/20 vision line. Now, if you've got astigmatism, then that's going to impact that rule of thumb and mean that it may not work quite as I've described. But yeah, that's just a general rule of thumb that may be of help for people who want to have a quick look at their prescription and get a rough indication of how that's going to impact them on the eye test chart. My question for you today is, has your prescription been a problem to understand? Let me know in the comment section below. If you want to learn more about astigmatism, then you can hit the link over here and that will take you to my previous video on astigmatism. But if you want to learn more about whether you need glasses or not, or prescription related things, or the eye test chart, then you can have a look at the playlist over here and that will give you that information as well. So thank you for watching and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. Remember also just to check out the description box below and also leave me a comment as well below.